This video explains how FluidSIM works as a controller or process. These are the topics: structure, function and commissioning of the EasyPort, connection of FluidSIM and EasyPort, binary signals, connection of FluidSIM and EasyPort, analogue signals, FluidSIM the controller, magazine module, FluidSIM the process, programmable logic controller. Structure, function and commissioning of the EasyPort. The EasyPort is a USB interface with 16 binary inputs and outputs. The binary inputs and outputs process 24 volts is a high, and 0 volt is a low signal. The binary outputs can each be loaded with 0.7 amps. This means, for example, that hydraulic valves can be controlled directly. The binary inputs and outputs are combined on two ports, each with 8 I/O and supply voltage. If the binary inputs and outputs are to be connected via 4mm safety laboratory plugs, a universal connection unit is connected to a port of the EasyPort with a syslink cable. The EasyPort has 4 analog inputs and 2 analog outputs in the voltage range 0 to 10 volts, or minus 10 to plus 10 volts. The analog I/O are grouped on a 15-pin D subsocket. The pin assignment can be found in the datasheet. If the analog channels are to be connected via 4mm safety laboratory plugs, an analog connection unit is connected to the EasyPort with a 15-pin D subcable. There is a recommended standard 232 and a USB interface for the connection to the PC. Up to 8 EasyPorts can be connected to a PC. The 24-volt supply voltage is fed in via 2 screw terminals. The maximum current can be up to 11 amps depending on the connected actuators. The binary signals are displayed on the top of the EasyPort with LEDs. An LCD display shows the respective voltage of an analog channel and the current channel designation. The channels can be selected step by step with a button. The EasyPort housing is prepared for a quick-fix screw adapter, with which the EasyPort can be attached directly to the profile plate or to the laboratory trolley. The EasyPort requires a USB driver, which is supplied with the EasyPort or can be obtained from the Festo Didactic website. The ActiveX control must be installed to connect external software such as LabVIEW, Visual Basic or C++ and to update the firmware. The inputs and outputs can also be tested with the EasyPort demo application. Inputs and outputs can be read or controlled bit or byte. Connection of FluidSIM and EasyPort, binary signals. The FluidSIM standard library contains the symbols FluidSIM in and FluidSIM out for the binary signals. FluidSIM in captures the signals sent to FluidSIM via the EasyPort. FluidSIM out sends binary signals via the EasyPort. To read a binary signal, drag the FluidSIM in symbol onto the drawing area. An indicator light is connected to the FluidSIM in symbol for display. The direct EasyPort connection is already set in the properties, which can be accessed by double-clicking on the FluidSIM in icon. The serial interface can be selected manually or automatically. With the port number, port 1 or port 2 of the EasyPort is selected. In the example, a simulation box from Festo Didactic is connected to port 2 of the EasyPort. Port 2 is therefore selected in the drop-down menu. The module must be set if several EasyPorts are connected to the PC. In simulation mode, the signal from the switch on the simulation box is sent to the virtual indicator light in FluidSIM. Now one of the LEDs on the simmer box should be switched on. In FluidSIM, the FluidSIM icon, out, is dragged onto the canvas and connected to a manual switch. If the LED bit, 3, is to be switched on, the switch must be connected to connection, 3. In the simulation, the LED can now be switched on by FluidSIM. Processes or controllers can be connected to the ports of the EasyPort. Connection of FluidSIM and EasyPort, analog signals. There are also corresponding symbols in the library for analog signals. The potentiometer on the simulation box outputs a voltage that is to be displayed in FluidSIM. The symbol analog in is connected to a voltmeter. The properties do not have to be changed if only one EasyPort is used. Module 1 is already selected. In the simulation, the set value can be observed on the voltmeter. In this way, analog sensors can be connected directly to FluidSIM if the output signal is a voltage between 0 and 10 volts. A voltage output by FluidSIM is shown on the SIMU box's LCD display. To do this, a voltage divider is connected to a channel of analog out. A DC voltage between 0 and 10 volts is output. The current voltage can be read on the LCD display of the simulation box and on the EasyPort. The currents of the analog outputs are less than 20 milliamps. Motor control devices, frequency converters or proportional valves are controlled with the analog outputs. With the analog inputs and outputs, pressure, level and flow controls can be set up with FluidSIM in connection with the training devices for process automation. FluidSIM, the controller, magazine module. The EasyPort can be connected directly to the interface of the module using a SysLink cable. This connects all sensors and the 5 two-way solenoid valve to the EasyPort. In FluidSIM, controls can be implemented with relays, logical function blocks, digital technology or graphset. In the example, a graphset PLC is used as the controller. This processes the end position sensors of the ejection cylinder and the filling level sensor on the magazine as well as the start button. If workpieces are in the magazine, the ejection cylinder is retracted and the start button is pressed, a workpiece is pushed out of the magazine to a transfer position. The start button can also be implemented as a real button via the EasyPort. In the example, the button bit, 0, which uses the SIMU box as a start button. FluidSIM, the process, programmable logic controller. The electro-pneumatic circuit of the magazine module was created in FluidSIM. The sensor signals are transmitted to the PLC inputs via FluidSIM out and the valve is connected to an output of the PLC via FluidSIM in. The start button is virtually present in the model. If it is actuated, the real PLC controls the virtual 5 two-way solenoid valve in FluidSIM and the cylinder extends. The program execution on the PLC can be followed online on a computer. After the start condition has been checked, the solenoid valve is actuated and the cylinder in FluidSIM extends. With the EasyPort USB interface, the real and virtual worlds merge. Digital or graphset controls make it possible to experience the effects of programming on the real object. Real controllers can be reliably tested on safe virtual processes. Thank you for your attention.